Have you ever had a class with a peer who is constantly disrupting everyone's focus, annoying those around them, and who argues with adults? Well, for students at Southview Middle School, this was a recurring problem every day. Although behavioral disorders are different for every person involved, Johns Hopkins Medicine webpage defines behavioral disorders as behaviors that consistently break the rules, disrupt the lives of those around them, and defy authority. This definition describes Billy Stark's case to a T. Billy Stark was a student that most considered a misfit. He wore an oversized sweatshirt every day, smoked heavily and did drugs, and was just thought of as grungy and dirty. Moving from school to school and getting expelled was what some people considered a routine for Billy. None of the teachers wanted him as a student because of his poor attitude and undisciplined behavior. However, Mr. Solstick, the principal at Southview Middle School, decided that it was time for Billy's behavior to end. He wanted to help Billy become a better student and peer. So, he and a group of teachers that he met with every day decided that Mr. Banta would be the best fitting mentor for Billy. Mr. Banta was very well liked by all the students at Southview Middle School. And he had a real non-confrontational manner that was deemed to go best with Billy's demeanor. Billy would also have to meet with the school guidance counselor and take special ed classes along with meeting with a tutor every day. And on the first day of class, as most of the teachers would have guessed, Billy was disruptive and disrespectful. Mr. Banta was considerate of this, though, and decided to talk to Billy after class when all the students were gone. He regretted not telling the students of Billy's demeanor beforehand and wanted to take matters into his own hands. So when he talked to Billy, he denied his rude actions, but then a little while later was found smoking in the bathroom when he was caught by a janitor, which he also denied. But Mr. Solstick, the principal, set up a meeting with Billy's dad to talk about his actions, where he found out that Billy's mother had left them not too long before they moved. Mr. Solstick also found out that Billy's dad worked long hours at a pharmacy, and he even admitted to a drinking problem. But he said that he was over it and that he was not drinking anymore. Billy's dad also told Mr. Solstick that he wasn't ready to be a full-time parent and never expected it to happen. He always put off the parental duties to his wife, who left them. And during the meeting, it was decided that the school and Billy's dad would do everything possible to try to help Billy's problem. Mr. Banta tried relentlessly to help Billy succeed, but it's hard to help someone who doesn't want to be helped. Because Billy was so far behind in all his classes, he read at a third grade level, he had to be put in special ed classes, but he continued to be in Mr. Banta's classes for a few hours each day so he could make friends and integrate with the other students. On a good day in Mr. Banta's class, Billy was sullen, withdrawn, and sarcastic. On a bad day, he was angry, argumentative, and sometimes even threw things in a fit of rage, shouting and cussing. To help with this, Mr. Banta would take the students into a different classroom to allow Billy to calm down by himself. When Mr. Banta asked why Billy did these things, he complained that the other students got on his nerves, his mom was a witch, and his dad was making him mad, but it was never his fault. And although Billy had these outbursts, Mr. Banta could sometimes see the kid that Billy really was. And he wasn't very smart, but he was good at reading people and even reading himself. And at the end of the day, Mr. Banta realized he was exhausted and it was reflecting on his teaching. Many parents called the school to complain that their children weren't getting enough attention because Billy was causing so many disruptions. In the special ed classroom, teachers found that Billy's confidence was so low that he refused to do even the simplest of tasks. Teachers then conducted a functional behavioral analysis and decided that Billy needed to build his impulse control. They tried a reward system for Billy that most kids would appreciate, but he abused these powers. For example, when he did something good, the teachers allowed him to leave the classroom, but Billy spent this time in the bathroom smoking. So then they tried letting him get on the computer when he did something good, but he would just complain that it was lame and he didn't want to. So when the teachers realized that this didn't work, they interested Billy with comic books and computer ads, fun reads considered by most, but Billy just mocked the teachers and refused to read. So finally the teachers decided that something emotional, social, or biochemical was blocking him from learning and that he may have an undiagnosed learning disorder. After everything they tried, they came to the conclusion that there was just nothing they could do. After this, Billy and his father ended up moving to Indiana to be closer to his family, and although many were relieved that Billy was gone, some were partly disappointed that none of the efforts that they had made to help Billy worked. Eventually, they found out that Billy was sent to the juvenile detention center and lost track of him. Although the teachers were disappointed with their efforts, this is the reality of the situation. Many can try to help the Billies of the world, but only a few will succeed. However, if the efforts that Southview Middle School made happened in all schools, the likelihood of these types of students getting better would increase. Cases like Billy's need to be emphasized in schools more instead of being hidden and pushed away. That way, the Billies in all the schools could become successful.